A very good morning, dear students, 12th graders. I hope you all are fine. So in today's session, we are going to start with part A syllabus, that is related to the communication skill. And in this session, we are continuing with session 1. Session 1 is related to communication. So what is communication? Communication is a way to share your views or ideas in front of others. So it's a method to share your views or ideas in front of others. How many people will be involved in a communication? There will be at least 2% that are involved in the communication process. At least one will be the sender and another will be the receiver. And a communication can be performed with the help of specific language by using symbols, signs or behavior. It means communication can be presented either by verbal method, either by non-verbal method or either by visual communication. Now there are some parts of communication. For a effective communication, there are different types or key skills that are required to maintain a communication. It is listening, reading, writing and speaking. And speaking is a major component of communication. If a person has a capability to speak in multiple languages, he will be the perfect person, he will be the multi-purpose person and he will be the effective communicator between sender and receiver process. So speaking is the concept that includes the language. If a person is having a multiple language skill, he will be the perfect communicator either in India, either in other countries also. At bottom, we have given the process of communication. Which steps are included in the process of communication? Basically, in this process, sender is included, afterward encoding, channel, decoding, receiver and feedback. Who is the sender? Sender is the person who will send the message. Sender is the person who will send the message. And what is to be encoded? A message to be encoded, that is to be sent to the receiver. Encoding means to say transfer of original message to the another form. It means anybody on network should not be understand. Anybody on network cannot be changed the message sense. That's why encoding is performed. And encoding is always performed on which level? It is performed on sender level. Next type is channel. Channel is the medium how a person wants to transfer data, by using verbal or by using non-verbal method. It is a medium. The person is sending a message by speaking, by writing, by gestures, by posture or by visual representation. And decoding is the process that is performed on receiver end that will convert the message from another form to the original form. It will decode the message in original form. Here message converted in other form and on receiver side message will be converted in the original form. After converted in the original form, the message is received by the receiver. And there will be a last step, that is major step. Without that, communication process is not fulfilled. That is known as feedback. And feedback is directly between sender and receiver. And feedback either can be of three types. It can be a positive feedback, it can be a negative feedback, or either it can be a no feedback. What is positive feedback? That is supporting to the sender view. Negative feedback, receiver is not accepting the views of sender, he wants some changes. Receiver wants to give their idea and suggestion for changing in a view. And what is your no feedback? No feedback in view, receiver is fully disagreed from the idea of sender. So this will read in next session. So afterward, next topic, that is active listening. Now before discussing the concept of active listening, we need to concentrate on some key points. What is effective communication? Effective communication is a method of communication that will provide the effectiveness of your communication idea. Effective communication includes three concepts: clear, concise and accurate. Clear, what is the meaning of clear? The statement words are using that should convey the exact message that is to be shared with a person. It should be very clear. Concise, a statement should be up to point. A statement should be to the point. A statement should be in a very simple sentence. A statement should be very brief. in a brief form. It is a concise method. And what is accurate? Whatsoever we are discussing, whatsoever we are sharing, the person should use a factual statement. Facts should be there at each statement. Now I will discuss one example about clear, concise and accurate communication. Like in first sentence, now see about the fact of clear statement. Here we have two sentences. Now you will understand which one is clear. In first sentence, what is written? He went to his manager and said, please allow me to reach office at 11 on Thursday, 11th June 2019. And I have an appointment with a dentist. So a person is speaking, please allow me to arrive office at 11 on Thursday, 18 June 2019, due to appointment with a doctor. This is first statement. Now listen to the second one. He went to the manager and said, please allow me to reach late to office on Tuesday, 21st June 2019, as I have an appointment with a doctor. Which statement is more clear? Statement number one is more clear because in that statement, time is also mentioned, date is also mentioned. So as per the concept of clear communication, the statement that is given by the person, he went to his manager and said, please allow me to reach office at 11 on 21st June 2019, as I have an appointment with a doctor. It is a clear statement. What is concise method? Now I'll again speak two statements, try to understand. The manager replied, all right, you may come late. All right, you may come late. And second statement, the manager replied, all right, you may come late, but it is a matter of great concern that most employees come late and you are also developing the same habit. First statement is, all right, you can come late. Second statement, the manager replied, all right, you may come late, but it is a matter of great concern that most employees come late and you are also developing the same habit. In this statement, which one is concise statement? Concise statement is first one. Now you can see that in the second sentence, there is no need to tell the employee about the concern of others. So statement number one is correct. The manager said or replied, all right, you can come late. Third statement, accurate. How it is accurate? Again, two statements. She informed the officer that 50% of the books given for binding has been completed. She informed in the office that 50% books has been given for binding has been completed. In second statement, she informed to the office most of the books given for binding have been completed. Most of the books given for binding has been completed. Which one is accurate statement? Try to find out. Now you can see that in the first sentence, a measurable information is mentioned because they have written 50% book has been completed that are given for binding. A measurement is given, that's why accurate statement is there. That is first statement. In that, what is written? She informed the office that 50% of the books given for binding has been completed. This is the concept of accurate statement or factual statement. Now next topic is listening skill. A person should have a capability to listen to the other. A person should have a listening skill to listen to the other. Why it is important that listening skill should be there? Why we will listen to the person? There are some reasons. We listen to obtain our information. Whatsoever we want to get, we want to get the information. We listen to the person to understand. We listen to the person to enjoy. We listen to the person to learn something. We listen to the person to create relationship between sender and receiver or between speaker and listener. And we listen to the person to resolve their conflicts or any different types of problems or queries that will be asked from the sender side. Next concept, that is active listening. As the name suggests, in which a person is active who is listening to the speaker. So active listening, it comprises a desire to comprehend as well as offer support and empathy to the speaker. It means speaker should feel that someone is listening in a professional way, someone is attentive, and you should be attentive in a proper sense. Your ear should be open, eyes should be open. You should listen to the person. You should reply to the person on the query session. You can ask question to the person. These are the concept of active listening. It means your concentration will affect in the effective listening. There are some major factors that will affect the quality of effective listening. First factor is that is eye contact. If you are maintaining a good eye contact with a speaker, you are having a perfect eye contact with the speaker, automatically you will listen in a effective manner, you will understand the person, you will concentrate more to the person, or you will get the knowledge about the content from the person, whatsoever he want to present. Gestures are also the major effect. Like you are sitting straight, it means you are confident, you are listening to the person in a very good way. You are tilting your head, it means you are listening. Your eye contact is good, it means you are listening. If you are asking query in between of session, you are listening to the customer. These all will affect your active listening factors. Third factor, that is avoiding the distraction. If due to some network problem we are not able to communicate, in that case we should avoid the distraction, we should avoid the problem and we should remove the problem. For example, reducing the ringtone of your mobile phone or switching it off while attending a meeting. Because mobile is the major concept that will create the distraction, so you should do your mobile on silent mode, or you will reduce the ringtone of your mobile while you are attending any meeting. It is also the factor that will affect the effective listening. And fourth one, it is giving feedback. After completion of session, after completion of meeting, you have a capability to tell the feedback, you are satisfied or not, what you have learned, or what's your suggestion about a specific meeting. So these are some factors that will affect the active listening while you are listening to the speaker. Now next concept is stages of listening. There are five stages of listening. First one is receiving, second is understanding, third is remembering, fourth one is evaluating, and fifth one is responding. Receiving means to say, listen to the customer attentively. Whatsoever is speaking, listen to the person attentively. Understanding means, whatsoever the person or speaker has informed, the agreement should be proper. It means you should understand what the person wants to say. Understand the agreement, understand the person, what he is speaking in front of audience. Remembering, try to retrieve the information from your past experience. Last time you have attended any meeting or seminar, try to retrieve the information from past expertise experience. And evaluating is step of judging or finding the quality level at which level speaker is contacting. It's the part of feedback. And responding, if any speaker will ask you about the topic, how it was, what was your response, what you are saying about the concept that is discussed by the speaker. So concept of stages are, different stages are receiving, understanding, remembering, evaluating, and responding. These are some factors that will make sure that you are an active listener. You are listening attentively. First one is remove eye contact, show, pay, emphasize, clarify doubts, and tune. First one is remove. Always try to remove the distraction. It means the factor that will spoil, that will create noise in a meeting, try to remove all the distraction. Like mobile should be on silent mode. Eye contact, whenever you are sitting in any meeting or seminar, always look at the speaker. Speaker should feel that you are interested in the views of speaker. Third one is show. Show your interest through some gestures, like tilting your head, giving positive response by using your gestures, face expressions. That is the show concept. It will show that you are listening. And always pay attention and make feel to the person that you are listening. It means focus on what the speaker is speaking to the audience. And fifth point, empathize. Try to feel the emotions of speaker, what he want to present. The emotion of speaker are positive, negative, how much serious about he is about the concept. That is the empathize. And sixth one is clarify the doubts. If you are having any problem, you are having any suggestion, you can make it clear by asking the questions. And seventh one is tune. wait for the speaker to finish the session. Afterward, you can ask your queries. It means don't interrupt in between when the speaker is speaking. Let the speaker to finish the concept. Afterward, you can ask your query session. In query session, speaker will ask for the queries. Then you can put up your questions in front of speaker for clearing your doubts. Overall, we can speak that to make it sure that you are active listener or not. For that, we have made the word that is respect. R-E-S-P-E-C-T. This is the concept for make sure that you are an active listener or your active listening skill you are having. So thank you. Have a nice day for this session. It is session 1 of unit 1, communication skill. In next video, we will meet with the next session. Thank you. Have a nice day for this session. Thank you so much.